I'm DJ Premier, and I present to you So What's Up.
Okay, computer. Run it back.
So what's up? Let's go, let's go. We keep on mentioning DITC, Digging in the Crates Crew, because there's so many dimensions to them. Obviously, the beginning of it is Showbiz and Diamond D, Lord Finesse, AG, Fat Joe included as well. That's the core. And then it expanded to other members down the line, which were, I'ma bag it up a little bit because I'm gonna get to how the dimensions got to the present one. 1991. Two incredible MCs with lyrical skills everywhere across the board. Both from Queens, different areas. One is named Prince Poe. The other one is Pharoah Monch. They are called Organized Confusion. Their debut album in 91 really set off a whole nother realm of just dopeness, man, when it came to groups that had their own identity, their own style, and no one sounded alike, and they just really put together a masterpiece of a debut album. The first look we got on them is when they did a video called Fudge Pudge. The Video Music Box days, where that's all you could rely on. You would also have your MTVs and BETs, but Video Music Box, shout to Ralph McDaniels and the Vid Kid, Lionel Martin, they would play so many things that really resonated just around the city of New York that you would really not catch it anywhere else. It hadn't expanded to a humongous video base at that time, so you could always catch it there. We saw Fudge Pudge, and then right at the end of the third verse that was coming in, another dude pops up who we're like, well, who is this? He goes by the name of OC. Now, the reason why OC was on this record, because at the time, when he was living in Queens, he was next door neighbors with Pharoah Monch. That's how that got started. Now, as you start to forward up, we're talking about 1994. Well, we'll go back to about 93 first. Shout to The Source, which was our Bible of hip hop when it was in that era of the early 90s. 1993 going into 94, they had a Source tour. Lord Finesse was on that tour. OC was on that tour, and so was Buck Wild, and a DJ and dope producer who's also part of DITC. See the dimensions? Buck Wild was DJing for Lord Finesse. He met OC, they gelled, and then they started to work on a demo. That demo became the album that led into his debut on our former label that Gangstar was on called Wild Pitch Records, where I got my start. Also, he was a member of Wild Pitch at the time, and the debut album was called Word Life. Shout out to DJ OG, who also was friends with Buck Wild, which also transpired into him hanging with OC a lot and doing production for him as well. And OG is another extension of the DITC family. It's just so many versions. I'm a member, you know what I'm saying? So when Word Life debuted, it had a nice boost before the album dropped. It jumped to a whole nother level of one of the most classic hip hop records ever in time. And that's a fact. The single was called Time's Up, and it was produced by Buck Wild. And because of that record, all of a sudden everybody's taking notice just beyond the status that he started with when he appeared on Organized Confusion's album. And Organized Confusion just continues to just be a problem. They're a problem all the time. I can't help smushing up my face like that. They're actually a problem. Can't wait till they do something new. So as things progressed, now we're going into 1996 into 97. I am a part of bringing artists to Payday Records through my former manager who managed Gangstar, Patrick Moxie. Showbiz and AG were one of the first to sign to the, but we were all friends that were just a part of getting connected to people that really felt the music, and Patrick wanted to put Showbiz and AG's EP, Soul Clap, out, which led to their debut album, Runaway Slave. Now moving forward into the other family members that come from the Gangstar Foundation, Big Shug, Jay with the Damager, Group Home, even Dub C, shout to the West Side, Dub C also had a one-off album that went through Payday as well. But backing up to 96, 97, OC went from Wild Pitch Records also to joining Payday Records, and we were all just collectively put together to make sure that his sophomore album had the next level of punch to it, which it did, and the same producers were a part of it. Buck Wild, OG, But then an extended part of the album, myself, DJ Premier, Showbiz, Lord Finesse, the Beat Miners, shout to Evil D and Mr. Walt. Now, as we all know where our direction is supposed to go, everybody starts to participate in creating their own tracks. This has been a really big request for songs that we're asking, what do you want me to speak on? And there it is, the disc. My World. For those that are late, the sounds that make the beats that I construct are saved on this floppy disk right here. And once it's saved on here, it is transferred into a device called the S950 Akai Sampler, and it is triggered. Trigger means the buttons that you push once they are linked into a device called a MIDI cable where they can read each other. Next thing you have is this being played into the system so that you can program a track, or like we call it, a beat. When I started looking for samples, it has to be something that makes me feel like I can transfer it into a beat format, but it'll match the artist. So when I found the sample and the whistle playing with the music, it just immediately said, I could flip that. That's what it's all about. Something just catches your ear and you're like, yo, I could do something to that. Once you feel that feeling, then you go in and start to just think deep on how you can make the next snap. You know what I'm saying? Not just this, it's gotta be So when I started to, you know, construct the track, I played it for OC and he said, we're off to something. And I'll never forget, shout to the icon Slick Rick. I just love that his first opening line was, my nigga Slick Rick said, right when the beat drops. When you insert this into the S950 sampler and link it all together, you get this.
Bust it, that nigga Slick Rick said, I waited a long time sweating it. I got jerk, but now I'm getting it. Hazy like asthma, bizarre disaster. Stress almost hemming down from being the master.
I'm also known for doing like intros that come on before the track starts. Once we made the construction of My World, we were like, it's gotta have a dope intro to really make it set off. Being that that was also saved on the exact same disc, we back up one more time to go forward. But here's how it began, and it went like this.
Yeah, you know, shit is wild. Can't complain though, I'm alive, healthy and all of that. Know what I'm saying? Just trying to do my thing. Praise the all.
Oh man, there you have it. Short and sweet, but still informative to a great, 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 great artist. And shout to the entire DITC, of course, rest in peace to Big L. Shout to Showbiz, AG, Lord Finesse, Diamond D, Fat Joe, Buck Wild, and OC. I want to say a special shout out to one of OC's homies that we met during the making of this album. He goes by the name of Uni. I just got news from OC that he passed, so I want to say a special rest in peace to him. We love you, brother. You were a part of being there when this was done, so this is dedicated to you. Salute the floppy disk, and that's what's up.
It's my world, and I won't stop. And if you stand in my way, you're bound to get dropped. Say, it's my world, and I won't stop. And if you stand in my way, you're bound to get dropped. Say, it's my world, and I won't stop. And if you stand in my way, you're bound to get dropped. Say, it's my world, and I won't stop. And if you stand in my way, you're bound to get dropped.